Hello. This is the Lego Star Wars Darth Vader transformation set for 2017. It's the second such set that they have made, depicting this exact same scene from near the very end of Revenge of the Sith. I think this is a huge improvement over the prior one. It makes for a nice little scene that is, I think, actually displayable. Plus, it also has some play features built into it. So it's a nice balance and has a good number of figures for something of this size as well. It picks up just after Vader has received his prosthetic limbs, his robotics, and we'll take a closer look at that figure as well. The bed is angled up just a little bit more than I would like it to be, but it presents the figure pretty well there. And, you know, it's kind of a round or rounded room, and they've approximated that with geometric shapes around the outside, which look pretty good. The white plates represent the lit sections of the floor, which is good. However, that section in the center there, that's my white table underneath. So that actually is see-through. If you put that on like a wooden table or something, you actually see the wood through, you know, whatever is underneath. So I wish that had actually been filled in. The key feature of this, of course, is the transformation itself, which uses just this over here, this knob. There's a very small assembly that goes through here, and there's a universal joint, and it just allows you to flip the whole thing around, flip the table around. And you're supposed to do it really, really fast so nobody notices, but we know what's actually going on. You're just switching between two different figures. Again, we'll look at the figures up close in just a minute. But my favorite thing about this set is what happens next, sequentially. Because, look, there's Vader's helmet. And that was kind of a dramatic scene of you know, putting his helmet on. They let you do that. They let you do that part of it. Bringing this in, lining it up, actually placing it on his head fully, and then you can retract this. That is excellent. It's perfect. I love it. Actually being able to put his helmet on there, and they wouldn't be able to do that with the old style. At least certainly not as well. It wouldn't have looked as good with the old style of Vader helmet. Now it's the two-part, you know, two-piece assembly. It's nice. They give you enough room for Palpatine to hang back here in the shadows and snicker and, you know, watch the transformation occur. They have a stand over here for a couple of lightsabers, one of them for Vader to use eventually, and the other one with the gold-colored hilt here is supposed to be Palpatine's one. It's not supposed to be the most accurate thing, but, you know, just they include the weapons for these two characters, and they include a place to put them. They have one of the spy droids or camera droids hanging around. It's interesting that I actually got one of the older versions of this arm from before the LEGO Ideas mech set, the Robo Suit set. This is one of the older ones from when the mold was worn out. It's actually loose and spins around. It's not supposed to be quite that loose. The newer ones aren't quite like that. Most folks hopefully will receive the newer ones so you can pose it more easily and won't fall off, but it's nice to have this to be able to move around. I wish it could move just a little bit more, but of course you can always just pick it up. It does have that clear stand there. I always appreciate clear stands included in sets for anything that's supposed to be hovering. And they have enough room with these platforms. You know, it's a fairly compact set, but there's enough room with these platforms to put the at least a couple of the important droids here, walking or land-based droids around here, two of the three that were included in this scene in the movie. And this is the bigger one. We'll take a closer look at these as well. You can just, you know, choose a spot to place it, and then you've got this one also. If you wanted to bring in other minifigures, you could, and if you have the regular old medical droid to add into this from another set, you could also add that in to make it even more complete. Overall, it's a nice presentation, and the spinning feature works just fine. And in the end, you can raise up the table by pushing that knob in. Just push it straight in, and the table dramatically comes up like so, which is exactly what you want to see. And then you can recreate one of those embarrassing George Lucasisms of the entire Star Wars franchise and saga, where he goes, And to go with that and to add a little more drama and action to the scene, they've got a couple of features on the sides here where you can just push down on either of these ball end pieces and they'll just knock some stuff out of the way. So that kind of simulates the destruction that occurred when, you know, he was going all crazy. It just knocks some things over. It depends on how you do it. It might look a little bit better. I think pushing stuff back actually makes for a better look. Yeah, it's all right. It's cool. I appreciate that being there. You don't have to use it if you don't want to, but it's a cool little thing. And the more things that you stack up on there, you can probably do a little bit of customization to make it even more dramatic. The key figure here is certainly the pre-transformation form of Vader on the left. They call him Anakin Skywalker in this set, but of course he already was Vader by this time. That's a pretty wretched print in a good way. I'm surprised they went so far in depicting all the scars and the burns, especially on the face. There's a lot of depth there, quite a lot of depth, a lot more than I expected they would ever actually introduce with some realistic shading to add some in there. The torn cloth for his chest, I think the cloth part looks good, but the flesh part underneath just doesn't get the color right. It's just a little bit too pale and probably just not opaque enough to be convincing to represent the flesh tone. I like the silver base color that they used for the legs. Now the hands are not silver, those are actually just dark bluish gray, but it's close enough, definitely close enough, and there's plenty of printing around the back as well. Man, they really, really committed to that, didn't they? Yeah, I like that. They do use the exact same head for the two versions of Vader, which totally makes sense. I mean, this is just before and just after the completion of the operations, so that is correct. I'm glad they did that, and I don't mind it one bit. I like the newer style of capes. No print on the back of the torso is unfortunate for Vader, especially with these newer style capes where it's a lot easier to flip them up and you can appreciate that printing if it's, you know, if it's available. None there for Palpatine either. I really like this version of Palpatine, mostly for his faces, both of them. Not so much because of the replication or the Legoification of the movie renditions of Palpatine, but more because of what Lego did with this exact model here and these exact faces with their non-canonical spin-off comedy mini-series that they did for TV. There's just so much humor behind this face for me now. And I think it does a sufficient job of being serious enough in capturing the insanity of Palpatine. You know, he's not all there. He's not all right in the head, and this definitely shows that. And then here's a better look at the two main droids. The one on the left is seen in this scene in the movie picking a piece of charred material off the shoulder of Vader. That's a really nice build there, which makes maximum use of some very new parts. Not new for this set, not new for this season, but very recent relative to the age of Lego itself. However, it does have one new part that is new for this set, new for this season. It's a stud. That's new. That's something we've never seen before. A stud. I'm not joking. We've never gotten that before in that color. That is a gunmetal gray stud, ladies and gentlemen. Something that has not existed in Lego before, and I love it. I hope that they will make lots and lots and lots of those and make them very easy to acquire in many sets in the future. It's a great color to be able to have. And then the main surgical droid on the right with all the tools is a very different look from the original version that they did of this in the previous Vader transformation set. The last one was too bright in color. I feel like this one is possibly too dark. I think overall its main color should just be gray. I think it's close to like a dark bluish gray. I might be wrong on that, but from what I could see in the movie, it was definitely not black. But this is a good representation of the shape. I appreciate all the tools on there. Yeah, they're not gonna introduce new tools to be, you know, accurate to the surgical implements, but this totally makes sense in a Lego context, and I especially appreciate the couple of bottles on the side that you can actually see in this scene that have some kind of fluids in them. The droid on the left, you know, it's a tripod. How could they have done it any better? I don't know. I actually really appreciate the attempt, and I think that it's a good look. I don't think they could have done anything better than that without going much, much larger or very, very fragile. So I appreciate both of these. In all, I think this is a great step forward. I think that the whole thing is a good set. I think everything about it is good. Maybe it's not perfect. Maybe they will do better in the future, you know, do another version of it some years down the line. But for now, it kind of ticks all the boxes for me with price to part ratio, collectability, figures, build, displayability, and playability. And that's not easy to do, putting all of those things into one set, especially something this small and reasonably priced, I think. And I just especially love that helmet attachment feature. That's definitely the best thing to me. So that's it for my look at this set. Please share what you think about it with not only myself, but the rest of the viewers by leaving a comment down below. Thank you for watching, and for the last time,